So, in the last week, I maybe am just starting to consider the fact that maybe I'll get rid of the car someday. Upgrade, whatever you call it, change it. Just starting to consider that recently. I was saying, yeah, I'm getting a little bored with it now because there isn't any mods. So that's the first little topic here. My last few mods here that I've mentioned in the last couple videos are very expensive, $500 to $600 a piece. We're talking about the Club Sport rotors, the Bilstein setup, all $500, $600, $700 a piece. And I started thinking, and this was about a week ago, do I really want to put $300 or $400, $600 mods into this car at this point? And think about what I would get in return for that. That's a lot of money, guys. I put like $600 front rotors here. Probably feel zero different. Let me get my screen up, sorry. Probably get zero difference in feel, period. I save 2 pounds on each front corner only, which is the reason I want them, sure. But think about that. 600, might be 650, 700 chipped. For like 2 pounds less on a front wheel. Of course, it doesn't make sense, but that's why we're car enthusiasts. That's why we're car modders. It sounds so stupid to a normal person, but to me, it sounds, well, shoot, I can get even better performance out of my front just for a mere $600. So that was the train of thought in the last week. I was saying, I'm getting a little tired of it. The power just, I'm used to it, I guess is what it is. It's great. But I'm getting used to it, you know? And combined with thinking about those real expensive mods, I don't think that it's worth doing those extra last three or four steps versus what I would get out of it, you understand? So, as I've said a few times, I'd say it's done. Yeah, it'd be nice to have that other stuff, but another 3,000. This car doesn't need another 3,000 is kind of the whole point. So then a couple days ago, the WRX announcement came out. But before we get into that, we got a little housekeeping to do, a couple little checkups we're gonna do here. With the VAGCOM, this looks like the one. All right, let's get that ignition on. Probably have my stereo on, so I turned it off. What about mileage? I'll just document it. I can't even see it. I'm not moving my head. All right, so two things I wanted to do right here. First, I'm gonna lower my differential setting. It's strong currently. I just haven't been liking the car, and I feel that on turns. I don't think I like the strong setting, so I'm gonna think about medium or light or like lowest, whatever it is. Other thing I wanna do for our first check on these new spark plugs is we're gonna check for any hidden misfire codes, right? A lot of times the misfires would not cause a light, but could be hidden in there. And because of my spark plug gap that I didn't adjust, there's a 0.02 difference maybe from stockers that I, eyeballed to the spec. So I'm just interested if I see misfire codes in here. Oh, most definitely. I might tighten up that gap 0.02. I mean, is that even possible? It's so tiny. Also, I don't expect whatsoever to see any codes. And I would think I would feel a misfire on my foot, and I felt nothing. The plugs are great. I mean, everything's running fine. So first we'll go straight into the engine and see if we got any misfire codes. I don't hide nothing here. Fault codes. You will see the O2 sensor I have unplugged. Keep that in mind. Here we go. Sweet. Just the one that I talked about. So no, there is no misfire codes yet. Whatever. The car runs perfect. I did not touch the gap on those RS7 plugs. I'm sure you'll be fine, but again, I didn't pay for your car or your engine, so you make your own decisions. All right, and the other thing, the differential, I believe it's in ABS here. Adaptation or co. Honestly, I hardly ever do this. Here we go. So there it is, right there. Differential lock. I probably have to set a security code for this. I'm gonna try weak, because medium, I may not be able to tell much of a difference. I wanna experience both extremes, feel them out, and then decide if I want the middle or if I wanna leave it like this. So I'll do that, and it might tell me, I think it'll tell me I need a code. It's gonna reject. Yep, security access required. So you're just gonna pop back in the VAGCOM one screen, go to security access. There's a lot of people out today. And if you hover over this, you see that secret little screen, 20103. For some reason, I guess they expect everybody's gonna wanna change that and they'll come here and then the VAGCOM folks, I guess, throw in a little hint maybe? I think that's what they do. All right, let's do it, see if it takes a security code, first step. Okay, now like on your live session, you have that security code implanted, right? So then you just go back to adaptation, down to differential locks again, weak. I've always wondered what the standard is. Probably middle, right? Probably. All right, do it on weak. That's it. It's gonna reread the controller, or next step, or now. Oh, right now. Strong to weak. There we go. I'm not worried about any of those weird little bings. That's normal. And that's all I wanted to check on that. It's our little VAGCOM checkup. But I'm just gonna throw my spare tire back in the trunk. I don't really care that much about this weight anymore, and the car's doing good, and boost season's coming, and my car's already gonna be faster. So, of course, it's somehow related subconsciously to, you know, the tire issues I had, and luckily, I was able to bring this from my shed, but it sure would have been a lot easier if I had it in the car for, like, those situations. So, honestly, I don't think there's anything that I'm ever feeling just having a spare tire out, although there probably is, I'm just contradicting myself, because the rear actually goes up probably a quarter inch when you take out that spare, and that's also another reason why I'm gonna put it back in to actually lower the rear about a quarter inch, tighten up that rear, stop a little bounce, you know. You can't tell, especially with, well, I guess tires are always black, but black wheels, black tires, it's hard to tell, but I'm just gonna throw that spare in the trunk again, just for peace of mind mostly, but a little bit for the weight too, honestly. Next topic. I have recently taken off my padding for now. Yes, my 2018 came with padding. Some 18s didn't. After that, they almost never did. But I was surprised at how much more noise turbo and blow off or diverter valve I can hear. So let's go for a spin. I'll try and show you.
know. I'm going to start making the noises. I'm just going to get to a quieter part of the street. And I'll start pushing into it, and you'll listen to the nice turbo noises coming from the hood over there. Or intake, maybe. No, he's starting to higher gear. I messed that up. Fun for a couple days, and you know, I've had my fun. I'll probably put the padding back, meaning it starts to get a little annoying after a while, I'll admit. So I'm just showing you, I did see a bigger difference than I thought as far as removing that insulation, though. If you want to try it, if you're always looking for more noise, you'll literally hear a difference in your intake and everything, especially when you may be going to 1500 here and roll into it a little bit, try and get a nice suck here. I have to step into it more, and I can't do that on my own personal street. All right, what's next? Anything?
All right. Elephant in the room. You guys keep saying, come on, get to it, get to it. 2022 WRX. What a disaster. You've probably seen stuff popping up everywhere, all over the internet, Facebook, etc. Everybody hates it. Everybody's freaking out about it. It just looks ridiculous. It didn't gain any power. That's just my overall quick view on that. So remember that conversation we had at the start of this video? I was on that track. Then I watched two or three WRX review videos, real review, real drive, everything like that, real looks, and it just really made me rethink changing cars again. It made me appreciate what I have, right? Super clean. You guys will all get your own WRX information, but for those who are just too lazy to even bother, I can tell you that from the 2015 to 2021 gen and 22 and up, it gained 3 horsepower. That's what everybody's talking about. So it isn't like from 2021 to 22 it gained 3. That's the same number they've had since 2015. So 3 horsepower they improved in the last 6 years. Worthless, really. In all fairness, I do think that 2.4 is it, I think? The 2.4 is more robust, etc. Better overall, but it's still really sad. They should have gone at least 20. So circling back, now I'm not on that looking at next car kick again. I'm like, hey, I gotta keep remembering how much I love this, and I'm gonna just hate whatever I get next for a while, most likely, unless it's, you know, something I definitely know, WRX I know I like, a GTI I know I like, something like that. So I don't see a WRX in the cards at all. I hate the rear. The interior is hideous. It has the tall Ford Focus style, or Ford in general, center stack, super ugly with the side. It's horrible. Ugh. I wouldn't mind trying that special CVT. That's like, a few of the reviews said it doesn't rubber band. It does feel better than a standard CVT, but it's still a CVT. But I wouldn't mind, you know, feeling one someday for myself just to see. I mean, obviously, it's no DSG. Yeah, but that's overall disappointing. We've all been waiting for the WRX. I had planned on it probably being the car after this, and that's out the window. So there we go. Circling back even further to the mods then. I then changed my stance since then. I suppose I will just keep trickling mods into this. Not like I just have hundreds of dollars ready. I still haven't even saved half of for any of these mods on my list. It's a little slow. I just ordered some Atari junk to see if I can restore it, etc. Get a little money going, maybe get 500 going, and then purchase one kind of mod. I don't think I still don't want to deal with that front Bilstein job. So that may not be the first purchase. I don't know. I just do not want to do that job. I could definitely do it, but you know, I'm getting older. I'm getting more tired. My time's more valuable, but you know, I wouldn't want to pay anybody to do it either. All right, I'm getting off track. Let's finish with something special. Today on Atari Corner, we will be checking out Jungle Hunt, one of my all-time favorite games. So let's just get it going here. Wrong fire button. Okay, it's my bass button. Ever seen anybody do that round that quick? I didn't think so. I need to change this to my stick button. There we go. This is easier to manage. Running out of air. That noise is my knife stab. Stab! Stab! I'm afraid to try for a croc because I'll probably get eaten. Go! Oh, you see that? 300. Don't open your mouth. Oh, whoa! Air. Dive. Run for up. Woo! Must be at third level soon, guys. I love Jungle Hunt. Swimming through the river. Indiana Jones style. Guess we get a little air. We gotta almost be done. Come on, guys. It's ridiculous. Oh, that's a high diver. Whoa! Come on. Are you serious? How can this water level be this long? Alright, keep it going. Here we go. Third level. Boom! Now you can control the... Oh, I should have ducked. You can control the upper, lower, and left, right type of stuff. Duck! Woo! Jump! Whoa. You gotta really think about... Dang, am I over? One more. Think about, you know, if you're gonna go under, over, see the bounce, figure it out. Tricky. This is a little tricky. Oh! I hate the big ones. Oh, no. Go! It doesn't jump high enough or something. Go! There we go. Pushing up on the joystick. Again! Ooh. Oh, no. Duck! Oh! Skin my teeth, bro. Let's just run full... Oh, I still got a guy. Wow, this is my last guy. Alright. See what we got. Come on, bitch. Come on, bitch. Hey, isn't there supposed to be, it's the next, so let's see, I gotta run and jump over him as he's flying to me. Get a little closer. Something like that. Boom, boom. Okay. Ready? Oh my god, I did it. What? Another one? Okay. Right there, ready to run. Go! Oh no! And that was the Jungle Hunt game, guys. I hope you enjoyed that.